My name's Wayne Metter, and welcome to another awesome episode of Gardening here with me on my YouTube channel. I wanted to bring you along just a little bit of the kind of the interim process of this vertical grow tower. It'll be vertical grow tower 1.4. So it's been raining all day. I've got to get some more stuff in here, and I just haven't been able to work on it. I've been very stretched for my time recently, so I hope I can get this thing all up and running within this next week. I'll have plants in every one of the grow pots, if you will. So let me show you what I've been working on, what I've done with it, and what I made changes on today, and how I think it's going to improve things for the better. This was the first lettuce that I ever planted, and I planted a plant in each one of these pots. And I'm down to, well, I've got one of them that died fairly quickly. And then this one here, I broke off the other day. It was totally my accident, but I broke it off. So I'm gonna leave it in there and see if it'll grow out. Now take a look at this other lettuce. This is a bib lettuce. And I gotta say, the flavor on it's pretty darn good. It's just okay. It's not the best. Now this one over here has gotten, it's the same variety, but look at the leaves on it. I guess that means it's probably been a little overheated before. So if any of you, you know how to read leaves, I guess, a little bit better than I, please tell me. These are the leaves that I have going on. Here's a romaine that's growing out, and the one that was broken off is a romaine. And, you know, it may or may not come back. If it doesn't, then I'm going to just plant it again with something else. So let's take a look here at the tub. In the tub, I know it looks like a mess, but really, I promise it's not. This little piece here on the manifold, it's untapped for a reason, because I wanted to be able to relieve pressure. And if I'm relieving pressure like that, then it, you know, I can play with the settings a little bit more efficiently. There's a knob here to give me greater and lesser flow. And all of this manifold here all runs to the bottles that are lined up around the edge here. So let's take a look at that. I have all of them bound together, running out the hole in the side. The lid can go on here nice and neatly, and everything is hidden. And they all run up to the bottles here. Back at the bottles, I have a hole drilled. All in every single one of these, there's a hole, and I have a 2 gallon per hour dripper line put on these. Now, I simply had the 2 gallon per hour line because, or dripper, because I don't know what it's going to take. I know that the drip pattern should be something like this. Let's take a look at this. About that fast. Do you see how fast that drip is coming out? That's what I've been running the tower, or the volume of water in this one side of the tower, and that's what ended up growing these plants. So I think that's about the right volume of water. I don't have any other way to pinch this down. If y'all have an idea of something that works real well, or that would work to pinch that down, please let me know, because I'm going to need one here on the other side as well. And then here you can see how much that pump is pumping out of water without a dripper. And you can see here I've got some pots that are filled up, and these are ready to be planted. Let's talk just a little bit about the pump. This pump is a pump that I got from Bright Agritech, 550 gallons per hour. It's the Active Aqua Submersible 550. And I will put a link in the description of the video, and also in the blog post that's associated with this, to the purchase page on Bright Agritech's website. This pump was purchased for me by a good friend of mine, Rob Bob, who has a active YouTube channel down in down under, and he does aquaponics. He has a fish farm that he's building, and he does a lot of very unique gardening in his backyard, and I suggest you go and check him out. Thank you, Rob. I really do appreciate you helping me out with this setup, and I will continue to support you, man. I love what you're doing. Keep it up. So what I have here then is the pump, and it comes through this line. There's a quick disconnect here. It's just a garden hose disconnect, a Y. And again, I'm using garden hose fittings because I want this to be very easy to take apart and put back together. And then out of this Y, it runs into a sprinkler hose line, and one of the drip irrigation lines runs up and back down into each side of the tower. Now let's look at the bottles. Here's what I did today. I took all these bottles off and I wrapped them in duct tape. Now here's why I went with duct tape. If you look at these bottles here, I used the shiny reflective duct tape that you can use to kind of seam together. Well, I used it in my grow room to hold the Mylar together, and it's the same thing. This stuff works wonderful, and it blocks out the light. It's a pain in the butt to work with, but and it's a little more expensive than regular duct tape, but it blocks out more light. And a way for you to see that, and it's not even that sunny out, but do you see this line right here? This is where there's one layer of duct tape, and this is where there's two. I just missed a little bit while I was wrapping it. And then here you don't have that because I wrapped that one a little bit tighter. And on the bottom side, you know, I didn't get too uptight about that because I gotta say, there was hardly any algae in this setup. And it's been running for about 4 weeks now, if not more. The only algae that I found that I didn't clean was right in there. And, you know, I'll clean that out as soon as I swap out this side with new plants. So that's all I have for you right now. I hope it's helpful. I don't know. I'm still working on trying to get my nutrient mix right. Matter of fact, let's go take a look at that. Here's what I'm using for nutrients. It's the 41838 Master Blend Fertilizer from, Morgan County Seeds. And I was told that this is a really good fertilizer to use by Bobby, MHP Gardener. And then, and I think he mainly just sticks with that fertilizer. And then you have to supplement that with some calcium nitrate. And this is a 15.5, 5-pound bag of it. And I got this from Greenway Biotech on Amazon. And I'll put a link to all of these items below in the description and in the blog post. And then I'm also mixing in some Epsom salt. Now, thank you, Brock Hughes. I do want to say thank you to you, buddy, for helping me to get everything lined up and set up properly. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, because I'm still learning this stuff, but I think total dissolved solids, or a TDS meter, is the same as parts per million. Now, I could be all wrong here, but I think you can come up with the parts per million in your water mixture based on total dissolved solids. So this is a cool little tool to have. I'll put a link below in the description to where you can get this. I bought it on Amazon, and it's probably the best place to go to get it. I thought you'd enjoy this view. I figured that you'd like to see a view of it just a little bit further away. So you can see there, if you look at the top of the bottles on both sides, you can see one, the side with the duct tape is raised up a little bit, and that's because of the thickness of the duct tape as I put it back together. And so I foresee the other one happening like that as well.
Well, it's taken me a lot longer to get to this point than what I thought it would. I sure hope that you like what you see, and I will be willing to take any suggestions you have. So I put a couple of thumbnails here at the end of the video for you to go and check out. If you're a new subscriber, make sure you go and watch the About My Channel video and see if it's something that you want to be a part of. I'm on a mission to make the world a better place, and I think that it's gonna take all of us to make that happen. So more next time. Please give us a thumbs up if you like the video, and share it with others so that we can change the world. God bless you.